Roads have made our lives so much easier. Even simple tasks like buying groceries have become easier and safer with the introduction of roads. It has also helped in cutting down travel time by a huge margin. But not all roads are created equal. Living in cities, we tend to forget how the people in remote or mountainous regions travel daily. Extreme environments equal extreme roads, and most of them are incredibly dangerous to traverse on. Here are 12 roads that you should never drive on. Be sure to smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell for more such amazing content. Number 12. Inuvik Uklavik Ice Road, Canada. When it comes to extreme climates, Canada is no stranger to them. The northern parts of the Northwest Territories and Quebec have long and harsh winters. With very little rain and a dry climate, the region has below freezing weather for most of the year. Being a landmass covering around 1/7 of the total area of Canada, it's not surprising that there are numerous communities of people living in these remote and hostile regions. Winters are especially hard on the indigenous communities living in this part of Canada. For example, the Inuvik-Uklavik Highway is a road which appears only during the frigid season. It connects around 10 different communities settled in the Northwestern Territories and serves as a lifeline for the people here. What makes this road dangerous and unlike others is that it's not a road at all. It's a waterway that freezes over during winter and connects the small town of Inuvik to the community of Uklavik. The 73-mile-long highway requires daily maintenance and radar systems to monitor the condition of the frozen road. When warmer seasons roll in, the entire highway melts and people have to rely on boats and barges to get around. So don't be surprised to see no traces of a highway here during summer. Number 11. The Road of Bones, Russia. Here's a road which probably isn't for the faint of heart. Russia is infamous for its harsh weather conditions, but people endure them, and the Road of Bones is a fine example of how tough it can get here. Also known as Kolyma Highway, this road passes through the Russian Far East and was built during the Soviet era. As the name suggests, it's literally a road littered with bones of people who built it. The Soviets used prisoners from a Russian labor camp to construct this road through harsh weather. The construction started way back in 1932 and took them 20 years to complete. Weather in Siberia can drop down to an incredible minus 50 degrees, and the prisoners slaved away through it. Those who managed to survive the brutal cold had to deal with mosquito-infested summers that plagued the region. Because of the harsh conditions, it was estimated that at least 25 people died every day while working on the road. Since the road was built over permafrost, digging mass graves for the laborers was out of the question. As a practical solution, the bones of the dead were added as part of the road construction. Around 250,000 people are known to have perished during this project. In recent years, the Russian government made upgrades to the road and even made a bypass which avoided a 125-mile stretch of this road which had the bones in it. What a terrifying thought to drive over such a place, right? Number 10. The Highway of Tears, Canada. Roads, like people, can have infamous and sinister reputations. Highway 16, or the Highway of Tears in Canada, is a road which has built up a very dark history over the years. This remote road passes through British Columbia and borders 23 First Nation communities along the 450-mile-long highway. But what makes this road infamous are the cases of disappearances and murder of several young girls and women along a small stretch of the road. Law enforcement claims that between 1969 to 2006, there have been 18 cases of murder and disappearance here. All of these cases give rise to the name the Highway of Tears. Since 2006, there have been several more cases, adding the total reports of incidents to 50, which in itself is a small portion of the total number of cases of woman homicide or disappearance in the whole of USA. In an effort to find more answers behind these mysterious cases, the federal government launched a national inquiry costing $31 million in 2015. Hopefully, in the near future, the strange case of the Highway of Tears can be put to rest. Number 9. The Stelvio Pass, Italy. If scenic winding roads set on treacherous steep mountains are your thing, then the Stelvio Pass in Italy might just be what you're looking for. The entire pass has a steep climb of 1.16 miles and drivers need to maneuver around 60 hairpin turns. What's worse, the barriers on the side of the road are incredibly small, so don't even think about speeding. The 180-degree corners are pretty tight, so you need to be fully present the whole time that you're driving down the Stelvio. Though the pass is not the highest nor the most dangerous road in the world, it is still a treacherous, windy road to travel on. It's also plagued by the alpine weather conditions, which further makes the whole thing even more dangerous. But the view makes it a worthy place to visit. Number 8. Gualiang Tunnel Road, China. When human will and hard work come together, we are capable of pretty incredible feats. One example which demonstrates this perfectly is the Gualiang Tunnel Road in China, which was constructed by 13 villagers over the course of 5 years. The 3-foot-wide, 16-foot-tall road located high up in the Taihang Mountains of the Henan Province was incredibly sculpted by local villagers on the face of the mountain using 4,000 hammers, chisels, and 12 tons of steel. Before its construction, the villagers had to rely on a narrow 720 steep mountain stairs to get in and out of the village. After the road was built, it made things a lot easier for the villagers and also attracted tons of tourists in its wake. The tunnel, being constructed by rudimentary means, has uneven walls inside and has more than 30 windows inside of different sizes overlooking the side of the mountain. The road is extremely narrow and mostly wide enough to allow only one-way traffic. But thanks to the hard work of the 13 villagers, the world can now marvel at the extent of human capabilities and enjoy the rare sights of Taihang. Number 7. OMG Road, Colorado. A road with a name which aptly describes what one might feel while driving on it, the OMG Road in Colorado is scary, to put it mildly. The gravel trail is known for its narrow roads with no guardrails and steep cliffs, while being set at an elevation of 7,581 to 9,383 feet. The road connects Idaho Springs to Central City and is best approached on a four-wheel drive with a high clearance and an experienced driver. The area is also victim to various weather phenomena like heavy snowfalls, landslides, and even avalanches. On top of that, you'll be maneuvering miles of hairpin turns set on high elevations and steep slopes. It's also filled with abandoned gold mines which run underneath the mountains and crisscross everywhere. The mines are a couple of hundred feet below the ground, which adds to the danger of potential cave-ins. What do you think about the OMG Road? Are you brave enough to drive here? Number 6. Tianmen Mountain Road, China. Don't be misled by the scenic beauty of this road. The Tianmen Mountain Road in China is a tricky patch of 7-mile road with tons of sharp turns. It's located within the Tianmen Mountain National Park and boasts spectacular, breathtaking views all along the route. The road ultimately takes you to a height of 4,000 feet above sea level after crossing 99 sharp turns. At the peak is the famous Heaven's Gate, which is a natural arch with about 999 steps leading to the top. This site is also known for being the stage of the 2018 Range Rover Sport Challenge, where Ho Pin Tung achieved the impossible by driving the SUV all the way to the peak of Heaven's Gate. The Tianmen Mountain Road is not open to the public except for special occasions, so people generally use the mountain cableways to catch the beautiful vistas of this region. Just look at that view. Number 5. Fairy Meadows Road, Pakistan. Meet one of the most dangerous roads on the planet. The Fairy Meadows Road is a road that should not be taken. Located at an altitude of 10,000 feet above sea level, this road is devoid of any guardrails, preventing people from falling off its steep cliffside. The gravel road has not seen any repairs since its construction by the villagers of the Nanga Parbat Mountain over hundreds of years ago. The road is also exposed to frequent avalanches and snowfalls, which can block parts of the route and can become extremely slippery. Because of this, the road is closed during winter and is best visited between the months of June and July, if you dare. The road gets narrower at the end, so large four-wheel vehicles can't pass through it. Because of its unstable condition and high terrain, the Fairy Meadows Road earned itself the rank of the second deadliest highway in the world in 2013. Number 4. Taroko Gorge Road, Taiwan. The Taroko Gorge Road in Taiwan is a feat of engineering which cuts through the side of a mountain and serves as a primary route for the delivery of commercial goods for many towns and cities in the country. The views are wonderful, but the path is dangerous nonetheless. It's filled with sharp and blind turns passing through narrow passes on the cliffside. Even though it is a dangerous road to drive on, it's incredibly busy because of its logistical value to the country of Taiwan. It's usually filled with tourists, massive tour buses, commercial vehicles, pedestrians, and two-wheelers as well. It's a tight squeeze, but that doesn't stop curious commuters. The Taroko Gorge Road connects the east and west coast and runs through unstable terrain, which is prone to heavy rain and earthquakes. The word Taroko means magnificent in the local language of the indigenous Truku tribe, and you can see why it's called so. The beauty of this area is worth making the trip here. Number 3. Le Passage de Gouin, France. Here's a very special road unlike any other. Meet the Vanishing Road in France. Le Passage de Gouin is a road which floods twice daily. It's a natural causeway between Beauvoir-sur-Mer and the island of Noirmoutier in Vendée on the Atlantic coast of France. It was first used back in the 16th century but continues to be in use even today by the locals as well as tourists. The causeway is equipped with digital panels which alert incoming commuters on whether the road is passable at that given moment. The 2.5-mile road was part of Stage 2 of the 1999 Tour de France race, but due to the nature of this causeway, it hindered the race by creating a 6-minute split after racers took a fall because of the slippery conditions. Needless to say, it was a bad idea adding this road into the race. Number 2. The James Dalton Highway, Alaska. If you like the idea of driving on a truly remote and isolated road, then add the James Dalton Highway in Alaska to your list. This 414-mile highway starts from Levin Good and ends at Prudhoe Bay and is incredibly barren of civilization. There are only 3 small towns which you'll come across while traveling down this road. It's so isolated that during its 7-hour journey, you don't have cell phone service, no radio reception, no rest stops, no restaurants, no mechanics, no gas stations, and no hospitals. So if you're brave enough to drive down the Dalton Highway, be sure to pack in enough provisions and first aid gear. The highway was constructed in 1974 and served as a service road during the construction of the Trans-Alaska Pipeline System. These days, it's used by 18-wheelers who are transporting goods into the oil fields in the region. If you think this road might be your cup of tea, then venture with caution. On the bright side, you'll be greeted by the picturesque Alaskan wilderness, including the forests and the tundra. Number 1. Old Yungas Road, Bolivia. Ending the list is one of the most treacherous roads on the planet. The Old Yungas Road is also known as Death Road in Bolivia, and it's claimed the lives of many because of its narrow and unguarded edges. Some estimates say that around 200 to 300 people die each year while traveling on this road by falling off the edge. The road starts at La Cumbre Pass at an altitude of 12,000 and travels down to the town of Coroico at an altitude of 4,000 feet. The entire road covers a distance of 43 miles and is the longest stretch of continuous downhill road in the whole world. The roads are extremely narrow, no wider than one vehicle wide, and there are no guardrails either. The surface of the road is mostly filled with gravel and loose rock, and the visibility can often be hindered by fog, dust, and clouds. Fortunately, in 2006, a new alternative route was constructed which is built with all the modern road safety features and a section that bypasses the most dangerous parts of the Old Yungas Road. If you're an adventure junkie, then you can still venture into the old road, but do so with caution and preparation. And there you go, 12 roads that you never want to drive on. Have you ever visited any of them? If so, what was your experience like? Do let us know in the comments. For more such interesting content, be sure to hit the like button, share, and subscribe. See you next time.